My shop computer is always in a mess and cluttered with cables and stuff. I recently got an idea how to solve this problem, so I started with cleaning the space and measuring it. But basically, the idea is how to make a cluster PC with not one, not two, not three, but four motherboards. Okay, I will briefly explain how it will look, and in order to give you an idea of my genius, I made a simple 3D model. My frame will be made from wood with plates at the bottom and the top to give it stability, and the motherboards will be connected with threaded rods. It's time to take the components out of the old computer, test the components and clean them. Preparations are a must, because once the computer is assembled, it will be more difficult to change some components. So preparations are very important. The idea is that I have different operating system at each level, so I also have four different setups. I will use old hardware and software, so I need to have different operating system like Windows 6P, Windows 7, Windows 10 and some Linux OS. Again, I'm using 3D models so that I can show you a little better what my idea is. And as I said, I will make the base of the wood because I have wood from pallets and it's easy to make. I think it will also look good. I clean the wood of nails and cut to size. I don't want to be very weak, but I don't want it to look bulky either. The strength is not so important because I plan to put threaded rods that will give additional strength to the structure itself. After a bit of sanding and drilling pilot holes to prevent the wood from splitting, another important step is screw it all the way with your hand, so it does not over tighten and the ends does not break. In order to give the structural additional strength, I put lower and upper part from plywood. The plywood is also from the pallet, and although it's quite uneven and questionable quality, I think that it will go well with the frame and with the shop where the walls are made from the same recycled plywood. I don't connect anything with the glue yet, only with screws, so it can be easily disassembled and structure can be easily modified. The main frame is there, and the next step is to drill holes through the structure which will guide the 4mm threaded rod. The bar will connect the motherboards, give them support, and I think 6 pieces will be enough. It's time for the first testing and threading the threaded rods. The holes even match. Well, but then... then the catastrophe. I don't even think about the fact that the threaded rod will interfere with the components themselves, such as the graphic cards and other PCI cards. I was only looking at how to support the motherboard so it doesn't sag. Not a good design for what I have in mind. So back to the drawing board. How do I put all the components without jeopardizing the stability? I cannot reduce the number of screws because motherboard will sag after heating, and it is a possibility that it will interfere with the PCI slots. The only way, if I think of using only 4 threaded rods, is to use some base or tray for the motherboard, and that's where I got the idea to use the plastics I have saved from disassembled LCD monitors. It is strong enough, easy to work with, and it will look good. First, I marked out the plastic plate as accurately as possible, and then I used it as a template for others. Now I learned my lesson, and before assembling the structure I did test the component's clearance, and the graphic card does not sit well because it rests on the plastic. But I solved that easily by first marking where the graphic support touches this plastic, then I drilled a pilot holes and finished cleaning a so-called channel with a Dremel tool. I did same for the PCI card also. Now it fits perfectly. There will be four threaded rods, three of which are thicker 8mm ones, and one is 4mm, because I want all motherboards to be connected to the same ground, and the thinnest one will pass through all four boards. With a little wiggle, all the panels fit into the place without any problems. The height of each panel is set approximately for now, because it can be easily adjusted later. On each side, before I put the nut for strength, a washer was put everywhere. It's time for the first test, and I really like how they turned out, this second version. There are some small problems, such as it's too heavy to move, it's too high, and it's too wobbly for now. I first moved the upper motherboard and shortened the screws, which are still a little too long and get in the way. I also covered it with a cloth so the shavings would not get in the board. I'm moving the top plate, and I will put it down to use it for double bottom, to add strength and to able to screw the wheels from the bottom. I add wheels to make it easier to move, because with all the components it is very difficult to lift it. In place of the top plate, I put another one, so that in the end I used 5 plastic plates in total. After that, I can measure the distance of each plate and slowly tighten the nut. I try not to tighten too much so the plastic does not break. I'm happy with how it turned out and how much stronger everything is now and how it looks. So the next step is adding wheels and testing with them for easier maintenance and upgrades. The front wheels also have a brake to ensure that does not move while it's on. After that, next to mount is the power supply. I didn't know how to mount them, but after a bit of browsing the internet, I came across 3D print brackets. I will put link in the description of the video. I like them because they will secure the power supply, the holes are adjustable and does not take up much space with this easy design. I can easily remove it because it's only held by 2 screws. I also found a lot of 3D prints for hard drive holders. I like this design for 3 drives, which is easy to mount, but it's necessary to use a little longer screws in order to be able to secure the disks. Although I have a little less space than I thought, I managed to combine the holders so it can be used for now, but I will try to find or make another design in the future, such as stackable holders. On how to design the power buttons and LED indicator, I came across a design with 2 buttons, which is great, because I need the power and reset switch. And I will put the magnet outside and LED diode inside the case. I use some cheap mechanical keyboard switches. I think I can still make a better design for LED indicator. So let me explain. I will drill holes through the small cable channel and connect LEDs in parallel. The diodes have a chip in them that randomly changes colors. For the test, I put it on the front to check it if it could be placed and connected like that, and I really liked it. It's quite subtle but also quite bright, so you can see which computer is on, which level is on. It's hard for me to capture what it looks like on camera. It's much brighter in person. Multiple computers work at once without any problems. I still have to install few operating systems, so I have choices, so I have a lot to choose from. As you notice, the rear end of the motherboard is facing forward. This is because I often put and remove cables, dongles, etc. This is my shop PC, so it fits me much better this way. It's easier for me to pull, turn, and it will come handy when connecting other components or when I will clean this cluster PC. All in all, I'm very satisfied with how it looks and functions, how it turned out, and it will be easy to add to the design if I see that something else needs to be added or changed. I hope you like this project too.